Clem, why don't you start off by telling us a little bit about this funding round? Why did you go with this group of investors, which includes, as Ed said, Salesforce, there's Google in there, Amazon, a bunch of big name tech companies?
Yeah, we're super excited about this ecosystem round. I think it's pretty unique. I haven't seen in the past a round with so many big players around the table. We have Salesforce, we have Google, we have Amazon, we have Nvidia, Intel, AMD, IBM, Qualcomm. I think it's a good signal for Hugging Face, obviously, with this kind of like collaborative platform that all these people and most of the AI builders are using. But also for open source AI in general, which is kind of like a trend that we've seen developing for the past few months.
One of the things that I'm curious about is how your company pivoted from its initial product. Initially, when I first met you years ago, you guys were working on a chatbot. So how did you go from chatbot to an AI platform that tons and tons of companies and individuals use to share their AI models with other people?
Yeah, it was quite a journey. It's really kind of like the community, the companies, the users that really drove us, right? We were building this conversational AI, and we were lucky to kind of like work for quite a long time on the underlying infrastructure for this conversational AI, which including the ability to kind of like have a lot of different models, a lot of different data sets, and kind of like build a system that makes sense. And when we started to kind of like share some of that with the community, something really wonderful happened, which is that open source contributors started to come in and kind of like contribute to the platform that we released in open source. Researchers started to kind of like share their models. So most of the open source AI models that you've heard of today have been added to the platform, like Bloom, for example, Llama 2, Llama, Llama 1, Llama 2, Llama Code that has been released today, Stable Diffusion, all these models have been added by the community, and that's really kind of like what drove us to go from this kind of like end use case to providing the platform for all AI builders.
Clem, what's so interesting though is that feels like there's this inherent sort of tension. You've got a community, an open source community, and at the same time trying to build an enterprise business that makes millions and millions of dollars for its investors. How do you treat your community within this sudden moment?
The good thing is that we can look at other examples, right? If you look at GitHub, they've done that quite well at a much larger scale than we are now, right? They have over 100 million users. They're kind of like the main platform for software engineers, similar to us being the main platform for AI builders. The way we approach that is by kind of like setting a clear boundary and kind of like a public and kind of like a strategy that when users are contributing, for example, publishing models in the open for others to use, it's free and it's always going to stay free, right? But when it's a company that is using for like their private commercial gain without contributing to the community, it's fair that we make money out of that. And the money that we make there is funding all the open source and all the free products that we can offer to develop the community.
Clem, I want to go back to the investors again and talk about not just the money, but the strategy. I understand this is an all cash round, but you share investors with some pretty big AI companies. Take Nvidia, for example, which has backed Inflection AI. When Mustafa Saliman came on to beat Bloomberg Technology with me, he didn't care about the cash. He cared about all the GPUs that he'd secured from NVIDIA. Is there any strategic or compute advantage to this group you've assembled?
So all these companies, they are using massively Hugging Face already and contributing massively to Hugging Face. Collectively, they have over 10,000 team members using the platform, and they have shared over 1,000 open models on Hugging Face. So we plan to kind of like double down on that. However, something that we wanted to do during this round is to make sure that there's no strings attached, there's no commitment on our sides in exchange to this investment. So it's a pure cash deal, really separated to some of the other commercial collaborations that we can have with these companies. Of course, having them aligned with us on the cap table is a good strategic advantage to keep developing our partnerships with these companies.
Clem, I'm really curious to know what you're planning to do with some of this money. You and I spoke the other day. You said you're going to put some of it in the bank. What are you going to do with the rest of it?
Yeah, we really think that, we're on the long-term technology trend here. Even if AI is all the rage right now, we're pretty early. Ultimately, we believe it's going to be the default paradigm to build all tech. So in this perspective, we're still early. So we want to make sure that, we're here and betting on the long term, right, on the next 10 years. However, we're going to use a little bit of this money to keep growing the team. We're 170 team members right now, and we're planning to keep hiring quite a lot. And as you know, hiring in AI right now is very, very competitive, especially for like the best people in science and engineering that we're looking for at Face CEO.